Topics on the Hill, NCU. Topics on the Hill, all you need to know about NCU. Come learn about your school and be in the know about the current affairs. If there is ever a time that you're in doubt, Topics on the Hill is here.
NCU's storied legacy extends beyond Jamaica's shores. And on today's episode of Topics on the Hill, we'll be exploring the life and ultimate success of a past student determined to do the same. I'm Ramon Gordon.
And I'm Amoy Harriet. Also on today's roster, Hall Feuds. We take a look at some of the events happening here on NCU's Mandeville campus.
Listen, we have a real eventful program planned for
Absolutely.
You all this evening. But before we jump into that, here's Devon Thomas with the Hilltop News Roundup.
Reporting live for the Hilltop Trumpet, I'm Javon Thomas. Coming up in the news, USM receives first pledge of $100,000. NCU student and former festival queen cops Governor General Award for Manchester. And USM Eastern Jamaica Regional Campus launches Street Feeding Project. United Student Movement President Ruel Hay has announced that the Member of Parliament for Manchester Southern has pledged to donate 100,000 Jamaican dollars to the recipient's fund. He made the announcement during a General Assembly at the Northern Caribbean University on February 11, when the fund was officially launched. The initiative, which is part of the regime's legacy project, is geared at assisting needy students both financially and with other basic needs. Northern Caribbean University student and 2018 Miss Manchester Festival Queen Crystal Scale was among the awardees of the 2020 Governor General Achievement Awards GGAA for the Parish of Manchester. The ceremony was held virtually on Thursday, February 11, on the Governor General's Program of Excellence YouTube channel and other social media platforms. Scale, who is a second-year student in the Northern Caribbean University's Department of Communication Studies, copped the award in the 18 to 24 age group category for Manchester. She said, "The award is humbling and encourages her to be bold and continue working hard, as well as to continue to help others around her." The United Student Movement's Eastern Jamaica Regional Campus, EJRC, has launched a street feeding project aimed at fulfilling the needs of community members during the coronavirus pandemic. The project, which was launched on Friday, February 12, is being spearheaded by USM's Vice President of the EJRC, Nordia Lyons, and her team. Lyons told the Hilltop Trumpet that all hands were on deck to provide food and monetary support to the residents of the area. She added that the street feeding initiative was a success, considering that the campus is fairly small, comprising mainly of nursing students as well as social work majors. And nevertheless, USM VP and her colleagues saw the need for the project and executed it. Reporting live for the Hilltop Trumpet, I'm Javon Thomas.
Welcome back to Topics on the Hill. If you are just joining us, we just started our show, and today is our second episode on the second season of Topics on the Hill, and indeed, I'm excited to go into our program. But just before we go into the program, Ramon, I'm sitting here with you.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
I am, well, coping. I'm trying to survive. Mm-hmm. I recently started my little fitness journey.
Yes,
so I'm
I
in
noticed.
The gym, I'm lifting mm-hmm. my weights, I'm doing my planks, I'm doing my sit-ups, I'm trying to get my body in order. But separate and apart from that, I've been spending a lot of time with myself, and I've been spending mm-hmm. a lot of time learning about myself, and that in and of itself has been incredibly fulfilling.
Absolutely.
And one of the main lessons that I've learned, you know, spending time with myself, is that sometimes you have to make sacrifices.
So
and
true.
Sometimes you have to take a leap of faith.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you're too comfortable, and in that comfort we become what? Stagnant.
That's so true.
And as growing adults and teenagers mm-hmm. and even elderly people, we cannot be stagnant.
That is so
yeah.
true.
How and are you doing?
I mean, like you, I am coping. You know,
yeah.
this is a new... Even though we've been doing this for months now, it is
yeah.
still fairly new. It's going to take some getting used to, you know, this online platform, online learning. But I've been able to manage, and I know that a lot of students watching right now can relate that it's taking some time to get
yeah.
used to it.
Yeah.
However, you have to recognize what your priorities are
yeah.
and decide that, okay, today I'm doing this,
yeah.
tomorrow I'm doing this, and
nice.
Just pace yourself, because you don't want
nice.
To be overworking yourself, but at the same time, you don't want to be procrastinating. So,
nice.
With God's help, we're taking it one step at a time.
And our first guest did just that in
mm-hmm.
studio with us, well, joining us via Zoom.
Mm-hmm.
We have 28-year-old Corey Gordon, the director of Core to You,
mm-hmm.
an independent courier that partners directly with Amazon to deliver packages to consumers.
The St. Catherine native has a very inspiring story, and indeed we are pleased to have her on our show today. But just before Miss Gordon come, here is a very brief report on her story.
30, but a small business owner is leading dozens of employees during the pandemic. CBS2's Dave Carlin introduces us to a young entrepreneur who is making history.
At 28 years old, Corey Gordon is CEO of Core to You, her own delivery business.
160 stops, you got this.
Gordon and her more than 50 employees are in the pressure-filled race to get packages for Amazon from the Staten Island Fulfillment Center to destinations in Brooklyn.
Bay Ridge, okay. We are an independent company that has been contracted by Amazon to offer this service, so we deliver on their behalf to customers.
Drive has dominated her life. Born and raised on the island of Jamaica, she's the eldest of 9 kids. After graduating Northern Caribbean University and moving to Brooklyn in 2013, jobs in sales and automotive operations had her longing to work for herself. Her big break was a program at Amazon, giving aspiring entrepreneurs tools for starting up companies to handle last mile deliveries. Of about 1,300 delivery service partners, she is the youngest, and she does it her way.
I only show up as my authentic self. I know nothing else. There's not a separation between the Jamaican side of myself and the professional Corey that you see today. I am all of that all together, and it's what makes me as successful as I am, I believe.
She has accomplished so much before the age of 30, and you think to enjoy it, she might slow down just a little bit? Nope. Quite the opposite.
There are other things that I'm going to do that are unrelated to my current company.
Give thanks to the Holy One.
She sings, plays guitar, and her future involves more building, more hiring, and being inspiring.
She's closer to my age, so it's like you can relate to her on many levels.
Corey is young, but that hasn't limited her trajectory at all. She's motivated. She's has proven results and success as a leader and a CEO of her own company, and we're honored to partner with her.
Just start. You will never feel 100% prepared for anything in life, because there are always going to be unknowns. So just do it.
She says to be like her, be fearless, stay true to yourself, and keep it moving. In Bloomfield, Staten Island, Dave Carlin, CBS2 News.
Be fearless, stay true to yourself, and keep it moving. What a spectacular story. Hi, Ms. Gordon. How are you doing?
Hi. I'm doing very well. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for being here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, before we jump deep into your story, I want to ask you this. Now, I grew up as an only child, Corey. So when I heard you had 8 siblings, my mind was, in essence, blown.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Tell me, what was that like, and how did that experience inform where you are today?
Well, you know what? I was an only child for about 15 years before my parents started having kids. So I can relate to you on that note. But it's been wonderful having my siblings. They are so interested in everything that I've got going on. And it's an honor to me to be able to inspire them with all that I'm doing. So I'm very grateful for them. But I love being an only child as well.
You came to NCU. What year did you start NCU? And what was your major?
I started in 2009, graduated in 2013. I majored in business administration with an emphasis in accounting.
Nice. Now, you left Jamaica in 2013 to pursue your goals, your dreams, your aspirations. That couldn't have been an easy decision. Well, let me not make an assumption. Was that an easy decision for you?
Well, that decision was made for me by my mom, and I'm glad that she did, because I did not want to leave Jamaica. Mm-hmm. She had been planning for many years for us to immigrate to the States. And as soon as I was done with college, she booked us a flight and we flew to North Carolina, where I lived for a few years before exploring the rest of the States.
Love that.
Now, Ramon, I want to backtrack a little bit. Miss Gordon, you are a former student of NCU. Tell us what your experience at NCU was like.
Oh, it was wonderful. I was involved in student government, as I'm sure you know. I was the vice president and the president of BASA, go BASA. I was also involved in the chamber choir, Hands of Praise. I did debating as well. So my life was very busy at NCU. And I think a large part of my success is to be credited for the student leadership that I was involved with at the school.
Now, it's very clear that from a very young age, you knew exactly the direction that you wanted to go. So tell us, what was or is your biggest motivation?
That's always been intrinsic for me. My dad is a fearless man who has tried many things in his life, and he's been very successful with his businesses. My mom is extremely resilient, and so I take a lot of courage from her. Throughout my life, they've always prepared a very safe space for me to express myself and try whatever I wanted to do. So I always felt like there were no limitations. So for me, my motivation is my personal commitment to excellence.
Right. Now, Corey, you did not wake up a titan, yeah? Mm-hmm. When you moved to North Carolina, you worked in the automotive industry, you worked in retail, and in your story I was reading, you worked long hours, and it was getting to you. And one day you just decided enough is enough, am I right?
Yeah, something like that.
No, girl, that is scary, that is terrifying. Leaving security for uncertainty. Mm-hmm. Tell me, how did you do it?
Wow. I mean, most of the rewards that I've experienced in life, I've gotten because I've taken really big risks. Mm-hmm. Nothing was terrifying to me. I never felt out of place. It just all felt like I was where I needed to be. So when I first moved to the States, I started working in retail sales as a sales associate at Nordstrom. Worked for about 6 months before I was promoted within the company to a managerial position, and then I was introduced to Tesla when I moved to the Northeast, and they brought me on board to manage their sales team before promoting me to manage operations across the tri-state area. Mm-hmm. So I've had my feet in a few different industries, but I feel that all of that was to prepare me for my role as chief executive officer in my company. And that to me is the most humbling experience of them all.
All right, let's talk about your company. You took the leap of faith and you reached out to Amazon, yeah? Give us the origin story.
Okay, so I was working for Tesla for a few years and I absolutely loved my job, but I was putting in 80 plus hours every week. And even though the company is very mission driven and that's what drew me to the company in the first place, I just needed something that was more personal and that felt like I was investing in my own. So one day I could possibly give back my company to my siblings, for example. So I simply went online and I was Googling business opportunities in my area and saw the advertisement for the Amazon Delivery Service Partner Program, read all the details, and it was so serendipitous how all the details of their requirements matched perfectly with my skills, my experience, my training that I have garnered over the years. So I applied. And then within, I think, 2 weeks, I had gotten a call to do a virtual interview with them. I did that interview. Subsequent to that, I was doing a series of interviews that were in person in Manhattan. And then I found out I was chosen, and all that was left was for me to formally register my business and start the process of hiring and getting everything together for launch. Mm-hmm.
And now you have over 50 employees working for you. Also, Corey, how are you doing this? How are you? You are 28 years old. Mm-hmm. A lot of people in the industry probably saying this young girl don't know what she's doing. She's enough. She's here. She's loud. She's present. Yeah. Mm-hmm. How are you doing this?
Sure. Well, you know what? If they're thinking that, that's their concern. That has nothing to do with me. Right. But when I first started the company, I was doing most of the work myself. So if you think about it, I did the licensing, the operations, payroll, hiring, recruiting, training, tax preparation, all of those details I was doing myself. And a lot of it I had to teach myself. So I had to read online. I was tapping into the resources of experienced business owners that were in my circle to get some information on the things that I didn't know that I didn't know. So I did a lot of it myself, but because of that, I was able to create the culture that I wanted in my company. And I'm happy to say today, I'm no longer involved in the daily operations because I've built a really successful team. I've hired an operations manager. I've got a number of supervisors who are working and managing the team for me. Mm-hmm. So I don't need to be there as much as I was when I first launched the company.
Miss Gordon, it's pretty evident that you do not intend to stop anytime soon. Where do you see yourself as well as this business in the next few years?
Definitely not stopping. We are planning to grow beyond where we are. So as you know, we service Staten Island and the Brooklyn areas in New York, and we are continually getting more routes from Amazon, and that's just a testament to the performance of the team. But separate from that, we're introducing a number of auxiliary services for the team because I'm really big on employee experience and making sure that they feel confident in the job and they feel recognized and appreciated by us. So we're offering a number of services to come later on this year for the team, as well as a few new business ventures that I'm working on.
Nice. Now, Corey, your story is so inspiring. Mm-hmm. You're living proof that once you put your mind to something, you can achieve it.
That's faith.
No matter how big it looks, mm-hmm. no matter how scary it looks, once you believe in yourself and your vision and your goals and go after it, you can achieve it. Mm-hmm. Now, I want you to give a message to a young entrepreneur out there right now. They may be nervous about taking the first step. They don't know what to do, how to do it, but they know that this is what they want to do. What do you say to them? What do you say to them?
Remain teachable. Wow. I said in my interview with CBS, and I'll stick by this, that there are so many things that are still ambiguous to me and that I'm learning on a daily basis. It doesn't matter how successful you are, all the training and experience that you've got in life, there are going to be things that you just do not know. And some of the best leaders and professionals I know are people who remain teachable. They recognize their limitations and they recognize their strengths, and they tap into that and lean on themselves when they recognize that they've got the expertise to do something, but they're also really good at self-reflecting and being honest to say, I'm not the best in this area. This is not my expertise. So let me tap into those around me who are much more experienced in this field. You will go so far in life if you are very transparent with yourself about who you are and what you know, and if you utilize the people who are around you. So be discerning, take advice, but make sure that you use the parts of those advice that are relevant to you, but always remain teachable.
Now, Corey, to close, I have one more question to ask you. Yeah, sure. Or one more thing to ask of you. This is a man's world, right? Misogyny is nasty. Mm-hmm. Division is nasty. The patriarchy is a beast. Am I right? Now, I asked you before to give advice to young entrepreneurs. Now, I want you to give some advice to young women across the world. How do you stand up and hold your own in a man's world?
The first thing is, do not explain your credibility. Do not tell them why you deserve to be in the room or why you are more qualified. shock them with how prepared you are, shock them with how intelligent you are, and just be authentic. There's no reason for you to explain to them why you're in the room or why you're deserving. Show up with your results.
Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, Corey Gordon, director of Core to You. Ladies and gentlemen, stay with us here on Topics on the Hill. On the other side of the break, I'm going to be speaking with the president of the Excelsior Club and the president of the Phil Melodia Club. We're going to be talking about hall feuds here on Topics on the Hill. Don't go too far.
Be in the know about your current affairs. If there is ever a time that you're in doubt, Topics on the Hill is here.
Listening to Topics on the Hill.
Topics on the Hill.
On your education and wellness station. To protect yourself from respiratory illnesses such as the coronavirus, use an alcohol-based hand sanitizer that contains at least 60% alcohol if soap and water are not available to cleanse your hands.
Hi, I'm Roel Hay, a student here at the Northern Caribbean University and the president of the United Student Movement Regime 2020-2021.
You must be wondering, what is the United Student Movement?
Otherwise known as USM, the purpose of this united inception is to serve and protect your interests as students.
As students ourselves, one of our main purposes is to advocate on your behalf.
Our financial sector ensures budgetary transparency and accountability for all the excited clubs on campus.
The United Student Movement is also here to foster your holistic development
and guide and protect your constitutional affairs as students.
We're here to aid in the development of your physical, mental,
and social well-being.
What?
We don't stop there. USM is there to ensure that your spiritual life is watered and nurtured
while staying focused and organized.
Your social life is still of great importance even during this COVID-19.
Therefore, we are here to ensure that you experience the best campus life has to offer virtually.
Under the United Student Movement, we are all one family, regardless of race and cultural background.
Accurate news and information is important, especially during this time. The United Student Movement's Hilltop Trumpet is here to keep you informed.
The United Student Movement is here to take you on a journey to developing your best self.
Topics on the Hill, NCU. Topics on the Hill, all you need to know about NCU.
Welcome back to Topics on the Hill, and if you're just joining us, on set with me now, I have the president of Phil Melodia and the president of the Excelsior Club. Please introduce yourselves.
Hello, everyone. My name is Janae Walker. I am the president of the Phil Melodia Club of Northern Caribbean University.
Welcome.
Hello, I'm Quinnan Ming, president of the Excelsior Club of Northern Caribbean University.
Now, these are clubs that are exclusive to the dorms, right?
They are.
There are some people who are not familiar with these clubs and what they do and what they stand for. Give me a breakdown.
You can go first.
Okay, the Excelsior Club is the leading organization for men at Northern Caribbean University. It's a social club, and our aim is to build leaders for the next generation. That is it, leadership.
Leadership.
Right, and the Phil Melodia Club is an amalgamation of the Jamaica Hall and Leila Reid Hall ladies that reside on the dorms. And our main goal is to promote unity amongst both dorms and also to develop the ladies holistically.
Now, as president of these clubs, I'm pretty sure that you have to plan a lot of social events. You have to keep the students engaged because campus life without community can be pretty what? Dull. So a part of that vision and a part of that mandate has led you guys to, what's the name of the thing? The Hall Feuds.
Right.
Tell me, give me a little history before we dive in.
Well, the Hall Feud is an annual Excelsior Club event. It started way back, well, not way back. It started back in 2018 by the then VP of Academics, Alex Jackson. He then continued it when he became president the following year, and it skipped a year, and then we had it this year again. So three episodes of Hall Feud has happened so far. And what it is, it's, I think, well, I'm an international student, so I've been watching a bit of TV. You all have this thing you guys call school challenge quiz. School challenge quiz.
Yeah.
It's somewhat similar. I think it's our own little version of that. And it's a competition between all three of the dorms. I guess Jenny will be more happy to say that J Hall won this time around, dethroning us, but we'll come back again next year.
So the competition tests a lot of things. General knowledge, math, and science. I'm surprised you guys didn't throw in a little Bible studies. Why these areas in particular?
Well, I think when it was initiated back in 2018, the VP wanted just something that is all-rounded, something that is holistic, because I think biblical knowledge is included as well. And it just adds to the holistic experience that we ought to have at NCU. And we just wanted to show that in our competition.
All right, now beyond this, what else do you guys do to keep the students engaged? Because I said this every week and I said this last season, everybody probably going to mock me when I say it again. We're living in what? Very unprecedented times. Yeah, COVID-19, the social distancing, everybody's online. How do you do this?
Okay, so the most important thing right now is to upkeep school spirit. And it's integral for us to promote school spirit in every chance that we get. So we try to host our virtual events as much as possible, but we also try to engage them as much as possible because it can be dissatisfying when you're constantly seeing virtual events. So we've had, for example, our versus, where you compete with another person. Our first person we had was Raheem Betty versus Giovanni Baker. So they'd have a sing-off, and it was well-received by the public, and I think that we are doing another one upcoming in about 2 weeks, so you can look out for that. And we just promote unity. We just act as a family. I can say with confidence that the dorms, mm-hmm. both the female and male dorms, are unified as one, mm-hmm. that we can call ourselves ex-Melodia sometimes. Mm-hmm. But that's basically where it's at, unity and...
Unity and community.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Something to say? Yeah, when it comes to how we keep students active, how we keep them involved in, on your word, unprecedented times, mm-hmm. these unprecedented times, I think, well, my way of doing things this time around, I think is really unusual, because in previous times, you know, every member organization, they come on at the beginning of the year, they plan a schedule of activities. But because of the time that we're in, we are so unsure of things. We don't, at the beginning of my tenure, I didn't know, one, if the dorms will be open, two, how many students will be on dorm, three, if we are going to have activities, what will be our limitations? So we couldn't really plan ahead. So I think I just had to create a basis of, okay, what do I want to rebrand? I want people to know that our brand is leadership. And then when we come, we'll assess the limitations and see how we can go forward.
Right. Now, the audience at home not seeing this, but mm-hmm. in the studio, we have, you're from the
Excelsior
Club.
Right.
And we have other people here.
Yes.
Right. So it's obvious that this club or these clubs and what they do is something that's spectacular,
right.
and something that's important.
Yes.
I want you to explain to me why it's important to you and why it's important to you.
Okay, sure.
Okay, so as I'm speaking from our biological perspective,
mm-hmm.
right, it is necessary for us to have a favorable climate mm. in order to thrive for any organism. And I think that this favorable climate would come from unity, mm-hmm. togetherness, and a well-fed community.
Mm-hmm.
If you're getting what I'm saying. So the favorable climate for me would be having our events, being able to be accountable for each person, developing ourselves socially, spiritually, mentally.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I just think it's very important for each lady that passes through the halls to leave with an impact or to leave as a different person
mm-hmm.
that can be very impactful in society. So it's very important to me for grooming them.
Mm-hmm. Now, beyond the events, I'm coming to you, Nicole.
Yeah, sure.
Beyond all the pomp and circumstance and the events, right? You talk about holistic development and mm-hmm. growth and how important it is to the whole being, the whole person. At Phil Melodia, how do you guys ensure that the needs of each woman that comes through your doors is met?
Okay, so we started our tenure with a survey
mm-hmm.
so that we can specially meet the needs of each lady.
Mm-hmm.
We started with a survey so we would know where each lady is at, what are the needs that need to be met.
Tell me, what are some of the needs? Tell me, what are some of the
okay,
needs?
Okay, so you have some individuals who are looking for leadership qualities.
Mm-hmm.
You have some who are looking to build their spiritual relationship with God. And you also have individuals who struggle financially, mentally, and so on. And we reach out to them we send them daily messages. We have Bible series. Each month is a different Bible series. So we had Fruits of the Spirit
mm-hmm.
and I Am, etc. So that's how we built them spiritually. And leadership-wise, we have had seminars with them. We've had book clubs with them where we'd all read books together, we come, we discuss it, and so on. So we have been trying to meet them as best as possible. You know, we can't meet everyone
mm-hmm.
in this short time, but we have been working, and we have mm-hmm. things in the pipeline coming, like our empowerment series.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Quinnell, what does the club mean to you?
What does the club mean to me? I think a few minutes ago you said that school life is dull. I think that's the word you use, dull. And I think it's something that I've noticed from probably my third year.
Mm-hmm.
And I think being appointed as president, I think that's one of the things that I really wanted to change, even if it's for the few men on the dorm, if I can't do the entire school.
Mm-hmm.
And I think because having a sense of belonging, a sense of identity, a sense of community, I think that's not only important to personal growth and development, but as an organization. I think it's very much important for young men or students in general to feel like, okay, I'm coming to college life and I'm part of something.
Mm-hmm.
I have my own shirt, I have my own flag, I have my friends. They just want to be a part of something. And I think that's what a lot of students expect when they come to college,
mm-hmm.
whether they're imagination of college life is built from what they see on TV, what someone told them in the past, but they just want to be a part of something. So I think that's one of the motivations I had and why the dorm means so much to me, because men, I want to be like for the men.
Men can be difficult though, can't they? Because many of them, especially those coming from far to live on campus, they don't want to open up, they don't want to be involved, they don't want to be a part of any community. They're here to do book and book alone. How do you encourage those men to participate?
Well, I'm a growing leader, and one thing that I've come to learn is that when you start to focus on people, you start to focus on how they react to certain things, and when you foresee reactions, you tend to deal with things differently. I guess it's just reading people's behavior, knowing how, knowing who you're dealing with, knowing what situations you're putting them into, and although you're trying to build leadership, there's not everything you will give anybody to do.
Right.
You people have their strengths and their weaknesses. So as a leader, it's my job to know that, to recognize it, and to just lead accordingly. And I think it's been working well for me so far.
What's the legacy? And this is a question to both of you.
Okay.
What legacy do you wish to leave after you step down?
I think the legacy I would love to leave. I want the men to come to appreciate what the XLC Club is and what the XLC Club should mean to people. I think the brand leadership, I want people to recognize the XLC Club as an organization which builds leaders, not just a place for us, a mother to just send her son away because she don't want to deal with him, make him live in one dorm, man. Or, you know, just let him live in the dorm because she's afraid of him being in the community. I want them to be intentional in sending their sons to say, okay, I want my son to be a leader, and I think this is the place that he needs to go. And I think that would be the greatest legacy for me.
I think, as I've been stressing, unity is one of the greatest impacts that I want to make, to unify both dorms, because for so many years, the two female dorms have been segregated. This ongoing feud. So I want to completely... That's...
Can't talk on air.
No, not on air.
But now, your dirty lounge is here.
But my main goal is to unify both dorms completely. I don't want to leave any tension unresolved. So that's the main thing that I want to take care of before I get out of office. And I also want to ensure that each lady that has been under our leadership leads with development holistically. So I want to ensure that each lady has a touch, even off the iceberg, even a tip, to say that the Film Melodia has taught me this, and I can go out in society and say that because of the Film Melodia Club, I am this person.
Mr. President, Madam President, great stuff. Thank you so much again for being here. Sure. Do you got talent? Because NCU sure does. Stay with us, because on the other side of the break, we're going to learn about a new talent competition coming to campus real soon, here on Topics on the Hill.
Topics on the Hill is here. Listening to Topics on the Hill. Topics on the Hill is here.
Later, Grandma.
Punchy?
I'm not at MFA right now, man.
You know, I was a hottie back in my time. But nowadays, since I'm a senior citizen, them no bother with me. If they only know most of the time I'm lonely, feel neglected, disrespected, and not to mention unappreciated.
Granny, slow pokey, come on, man.
You see what I mean?
Respect your senior citizens. They are Jamaica's treasures.
Ready to take your skin and hair to the next level? See the best version of you? We think it's time you got an upgrade. K-Shea's Organics has you covered with our one-of-a-kind hair and skin products, specially designed to cleanse and eliminate any issues that plague your skin. We want the best for you. Visit us on Instagram at kshays.organics or call us at 876-891-7784 to get your free consultation today. That's 876-891-7784. Kshays Organics, taking care of your skin and hair.
This isn't a movie. This is reality. Over 500 men die each year in Jamaica from prostate cancer.
Take a look on this. How are that information all about prostate cancer?
Oh man, I don't mind thinking that.
You look like a family man. Read this.
Prostate is a cancer that is a silent killer. If you wait until you feel the symptoms, you may only have 2 years to live.
You know what? I'm not making this quote, Michael.
You have a choice to make, gentlemen. You will get to see your children grow up and have their grandchildren get tested and get tested early.
A student here at the Northern Caribbean University and the president of the United Student Movement regime 2020-2021.
You must be wondering, what is the United Student Movement?
Otherwise known as USM, the purpose of this united inception is to serve and protect your interests as students.
As students ourselves, one of our main purposes is to advocate on your behalf.
Our financial sector ensures budgetary transparency and accountability for all the excited clubs on campus.
The United Student Movement is also here to foster your holistic development
and guide and protect your constitutional affairs as students.
We're here to aid in the development of your physical, mental,
and social well-being.
What?
We don't stop there. USM is there to ensure that your spiritual life is watered and nurtured.
While staying focused and organized.
Your social life is still of great importance even during this COVID-19.
Therefore, we are here to ensure that you experience the best campus life has to offer virtually.
Under the United Student Movement, we are all one family, regardless of race and cultural background.
Accurate news and information is important, especially during this time. The United Student Movement's Hilltop Trumpet is here to keep you informed.
The United Student Movement is here to take you on a journey to developing your best self.
Topics on the Hill, NCU. Topics on the Hill, all you need to know about NCU. Come learn about your school.
Welcome back to Topics on the Hill. Since the show started, we've been talking about what's been happening here on campus. And we have an upcoming event that I know a lot of students will be very, very excited about, a talent show. And I know that here at NCU, we have a very vast majority of talent. So students, this is a segment that you'd want to make sure that you're tuned into, all eyes and all ears. So this evening, I am joined by the Associate PRO for the USM Projects team, DeMarco Robinson, and Chanel Pompey, who is the Vice President of Social Affairs for ISSA, which is the International Student Association. Before we even start talking about the talent show, guys, how have you been doing? Because you're both students. How have you been doing?
Well, for me, I'm a nursing student, so during the based on the COVID-19 and studies and the club, it's been a lot. I'm doing good.
In one word, I am coping. School has been stressing, and I have to manage school versus other engagements. So it has been...
Absolutely. Okay. Continue holding on. Yes, first things first, talent show. What is this talent show? Tell us all about it.
So firstly, the talent show is called NCU Got Talent. So we want to almost like a spotlight for students who have talent. We want them to display their talents in a form of a competition. So it can help to motivate them because there'll be cash prizes. So keep on listening for that.
So when you say talent, because like I said earlier, here at NCU, we have a vast majority. Are you saying just singers and dancers or photographers and or videographers and all or other fuzz can join in? When you say talent, what exactly are you referring to? Is it everything?
Yes, it is everything. We want it, singers or dancers. However, please ensure that it is ethos friendly, keeping up with the university. We want to ensure that no matter what we put out on social media, we are upholding with our ethos. We want singers, I think you call it dub poems. Yes, even if you can do dub poems, we want all those type of talents. If you have a talent, then come and enter our competition.
And students, I know that this is a segment that a lot of you are tuned into right now. So if you have your questions, go ahead and send them via our live chat. So this talent show, only students? Is it only for students?
Well, this talent show is not only for students. Once you are a part of the NCU family, whether you're a lecturer, a worker, or anything of that sort, you basically can enter. Once you got a talent, of course. So whichever talent you have, you just enter and, you know, come enjoy.
I might just add, even alumni can join in this competition.
Wow. Okay, that's great. And how exactly do you guys plan to execute this program? Is it going to be online, face-to-face? What is it?
Well, what we're going to be using is our Instagrams, our social media platform. Platform for 2 weeks, we're going to have some elimination based on the most likes on our IG pages. So videos will be posted on ISA. Instagram page as well as Project Steam. Instagram pages. And then now we're going to have our final grand competition day on March 27. We're hoping to have that on campus, but you know, it's still pending. But we're hoping to have that on March 27th, whereby we'll have judges judging to determine who is going to win. Also, we're going to have the most likes on Instagram. So it's important that you keep up with social media when it comes to this talent competition.
All right, to hear that, students, persons with the most likes, right now you're going to want to start calling up your auntie and your uncle from foreign to tell them that you're going to post something and you need them to like it. So, DeMarco, tell us, how exactly can our students and lecturers enter this competition?
So, to enter this competition, you basically have to send us a video for us to vet it. Once it's ethos friendly, we will then give you the notification on which you can post it on your Instagram page and tag us so we can repost it, basically. That's basically it.
He said sent it to you guys. Where exactly? Email, Instagram?
Email, via email. Yes. So you will send it to the, what is it again? The NCU
Projects team
email.
And just to add, we also have an entry fee. So for students, the entry fee is $500. And for our staff, lecturers, and our alumni, this is going to be $1,000. Now, for our entry fee, you can go to the USM office to pay and collect your receipt. Or you can just send it via account number, which will be displayed during our promotion.
All right, so since there's an entry fee, or students and lecturers who are going to be, you know, joining, they'll be paying something. So going into this, they want to know that they're getting back some something. Yes. So let us know, what exactly is the grand prize?
So the grand prize for the, well, let me start at the bottom.
Yes,
For the third place, it's $5,000 in cash and prizes. Mm-hmm. For the second place, it's $10,000 in cash and prizes. Mm-hmm. And for the first place, is $20,000 in cash and prizes.
Yes.
So it's, yeah, it's something to look out for.
Your $500 can turn into $20,000 in cash and prizes.
That is absolutely great. And I think that this initiative is very good, especially in a time right now where you have a lot of our students online. They're under pressure. So this would kind of be like a breather for them. But I want to know, what influenced you guys to start this show?
Well, it was an initiative by the projects team, projects and special initiative team. So initially it was to be face-to-face, but due to the current pandemic, we had to go back to our drawing board and basically come up with this. So as you may realize, the competition is something similar to America Got Talent. So different talents come in for, well, basically trying to win one grand prize and a chance to represent NCU, basically. And yeah, that's how it came about. So it's from the projects team, and we wanted partnership, so that's how.
They reach out to ISA, where when they reach out to us, I went to my executive body and I discussed it with them. And I felt that it was a good initiative, seeing that it was COVID time. And basically with ISA, you know that we always have one of our biggest events is Confessions this year, and it was actually canceled this year. So we wanted something to, you know, still be innovative and fresh for our students, even for our students who are away. Seeing that we're international students, you know, some of us had to go back home or some of us are still in Jamaica. So we want something to still be connected with the students.
Yes, and I think that our students will appreciate this. Yes. I myself will appreciate this. I'm not going to tell you guys yet whether or not I intend on joining. So you said that the final show is going to be held on campus?
We're hoping that it will, but we cannot confirm it as yet. So it's still pending. However, if it's not on campus, it may be pre-recorded. And then on the final night, on March 27th, the winner will be announced. The winner, sorry, will be announced.
Okay, so for our students out there who might be fearing COVID right now, let them know some of the protocols that will be put in place for when they come in for the show, whether pre-recorded or live.
Okay, well, if it is live, we have to ensure that we have the standard amount of persons within the building according to the Jamaican government. So that's number one. Ensure that you have your mask, ensure that you're hand sanitized at the door, and even during the session you have to be hand sanitized. We want to ensure that you're 6 feet apart always and ensure that we're not gathering close by, because it's a time where COVID numbers are rising and we don't
especially
want
in
that
Mandeville.
To happen. Yes, especially in Mandeville, yes.
All right, absolutely. Now, just before you guys go, for those of our students out there who might have some, you know, a few more questions that probably it's not right now, but later a question might pop up in their head, where can they go to get those answers? Where can they find you guys?
So, because this is a partnership, basically, they can email the projects team, projects and special initiatives team, and they can email
ISC
also.
As well as go on our Instagram pages to check us out. We'll be starting our promotions hopefully by the ending of this week so that we can get the ball rolling. And hopefully you will see the promotions in your students' email, on Instagram, on WhatsApp, everywhere. So you will have contact information when it comes to that. So just look out on our IG pages as well as your students' email.
There you have it, students, for all our singers and dancers and poets out there, and even to you, our dear lecturers, yes. This talent show is just for you guys. So thank you, DeMarco and Chanel, for joining us today.
Thank you so much.
Yes. In all things that we do here at NCU, we have to have God right in the center of it. So at this time, we are going to have a prayer by Mr. Michael Morris.
Let us pray. Loving God and our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy most holy and matchless name. We thank you, O Lord, for life. We thank you for health and strength. We thank you for your care and your mercies. Indeed, you have been a good God to us, and for that, we pause to give you all the praise and all the glory because you really deserve it. We pray, O God, that you'll be with us in a special way. Pray that you will have your way in our lives even now. We ask, O God, that you will just continue to bless us and keep us, that you'll give us the power that we need to live according to your words. Keep us in the hollow palm of your hands. Continue to protect us and guide us. And just instill in us, O God, that which you'd want us to do. And may we be willing to follow. Be with all your young people. Give us the strength, O God, to live for you from day to day. Help us to be kind and loving to each other, so that as we live, those who do not know you might know you because of our lifestyle. Continue to bless, continue to guide, keep. I pray that you'll be with the United Student Movement and NCU in a special way. Pray that you will be with the every aspect, oh God, of every leg, every part of USM, especially the PRO, the Public Relations Officer Department. Pray that you'll just bless them, continue to be with their program, continue to bless it, and I pray that it will reach people for you, and that many people will come to you as a result and know you, whom to know is life eternal. Have your way in our life. We commit everything into your hands, telling you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you so much, Mr. Morris, for that prayer. Indeed, indeed. God is amazing, and we have to always have him in the center of everything. Right. Guys, we have come to the end of another episode. Ramon.
Yeah, it was a spectacular show.
Absolutely.
And every 2 weeks, I sit here, I'm reminded how grateful we should be
to
the folks at the Hilltop Trumpet and the United Students Movement for spearheading such a spectacular initiative. It's conversations like these that move a nation forward. It's conversations
like these
that help us become the best versions of ourselves. And I'm just grateful for the opportunity to be able to facilitate talks like these.
And I feel so proud to be among students right now who are making the most of their time here on earth. They're making the most of university. You know, we're going out and we're doing things and we're trying to broaden, you know, our entire development. And it was absolutely wonderful hearing from our students, from USM and all the other clubs that was mentioned in today's program.
Just a reminder that this program is not for us, it's for you.
Absolutely.
So if you'd like us to talk about something in particular, you can reach out to the USM on Instagram, on Facebook. You can reach out to me on Instagram at Ramon Rahal. You can reach out to Amoy. I don't know if you want to share your social media handles, but you can reach out to us and we'll be willing to, you know, be champions on your behalf.
Yes, absolutely. So until next time, students, viewers, everyone that was watching, tuned in today. I am Amoy Harriet.
And I'm Ramon Gordon. Until next time, walk good and stay safe.
Topics on the hill, all you need to know about NCU. Come learn about